Cari ospiti, cari amici dei cittadini del Mediterraneo, è mio piacere di stare qui a Venezia. Il mio italiano non è tanto bene, so I have to continue in English. I'm Ugo Nikolic, I'm coming from the city of Dubrovnik, from Independent Civil Initiative, and in my speech I will try to present you the situation in our city. After me, my colleague of mine, Petra Marchenko, will be telling you about the very important role of the civil initiatives and their activities that they are doing right now to address the issues that Dubrovnik is coping with. Listening to the speeches so far, I can say, and chatting with the people that yesterday evening, I can say Dubrovnik, during the history, Dubrovnik has a very, very long tradition of learning good practices from Venice, and we have been even able to improve some things. I see that issues that the Venice is struggling with today, as well as other Mediterranean cities, are pretty much the same. So I hope our joint forces will enable us to bring out the guidelines and to define the guidelines for policies that will enable more livable cities. So in my presentation I will be telling you about, we are coming from the city of Dubrovnik. It's located on the eastern Adriatic coast. It's a 40,000 inhabitants place situated under the Mount of Srđ. This is the aerial view of the old town of Dubrovnik. The origins of the city are dating back to the 7th century or even a little bit before. Nowadays the city is spread over the area of 5 kilometers long along the coast, inner part of the city. Tourism is the main economic activity in the city, so now we have issues regarding the stationary guests, which are handled by 30,000 beds in hotel and private accommodation, a little bit more than 30,000. 1 million tourists visit Dubrovnik every year, and they go to a little bit more than 3.5 overnight stays. And the annual growth of the tourists is a little bit more than 13%. The recent couple of years, we also have issues regarding the passengers coming by cruise ships. There is almost 1 million visitors coming by cruise ships, and for instance, during the peak days, 5 mega ships are able to disembark 7,000 visitors, comparing to 1,500 living inhabitants within the old city. You can imagine what is its stress for the infrastructure as well as for the people living within the city. We also have an issue with one-day visitors, the tourists coming from the inland, and the fact that there is no real mechanism to control that number and to route the traffic with such high number of tourists. One of the typical situations that looks at the city entrance, one of the city entrances, 3 years ago, 2 years ago, the mayor stated that things have gone far away beyond the limits. We are not even able to handle neither tourism is in danger, but the living city is in danger as well. So these are the typical results of that over-tourism situation. Streets within the old city, very similar to the narrow streets in Venice, which are congested by the tables from the restaurants, or not appropriate handling of the waste after the restaurants are being closed. The supply chain to the old city is also very, very questionable. So you have a number of trucks arriving to the city during the morning. It's very annoying for the citizens, but at the other time it's very dangerous for the heritage, because all those buildings are under huge pressure. So we also have a very hard environmental issues. For instance, our waste landfill is located in the vicinity of the town, It is endangering our water resources, and the water supply system that goes under the Mount of Turch is endangered through that vicinity. So the recent investments that have been undertaken have not been addressing those issues regularly. We are even going have special plans to build a golf course on top of that. On that mount, with the fact that it's going to even pose more risk to the environment. The other issue that we are coping with are those ones regarding to special planning. Detailed plans today are mostly financed by local investors, which is not good practice because they are interested in raising their own profits, not by which is very normal, not by looking at the public interest. And the actual policies lack the vision of delivering the special plans with focus on real and visionary special planning. So the citizen participation is not also strong enough. In the last 3 years, the local government districts have been functioning without representatives of the citizens. For instance, referendum results, which took place in 2013, the results of those referendum were not taken into account by actual politicians, and the strong political parties have really much influence based on their decisions made elsewhere, not at the city level. So that all lacks the result of the interest of the citizens for engaging and to start to roll the positive changes. Town itself is faced with a tremendous decrease in number of population. These are figures for the last 30 years, from 1970 to 2016. For instance, in the last 10 years, the population within the old city center, within the historic center, have decreased for more than 40%. At the same time, the number of accommodation units and the number of beds for tourists have raised for 100%. That is not sustainable for a long term period. For instance, today we have almost 37,000 beds, comparing to 42,000 inhabitants in whole region. Adding to that the accommodations are during the peak times almost full. Adding to that the cruise ships arrivals even raise the number of inhabitants. It seems that the town itself, without some disruptive change, is going to shift itself from the town to the resort. That's something that must be coped with. Regarding the employment distribution, almost 30% of the employees are in the tourist sector, in the accommodation and catering sector. Those sectors bring more than 70% of the income to the whole town today. And it also poses very high risk on the fluctuation, because you have the months with during the summertime we have the lack of the labor force. During the winter time, those numbers are decreased. So this is typical fluctuation during the. For instance, there is also risks posed by the respective UNESCO mission, which took place in October 2015. The guidelines set up by the UNESCO mission was to try to limit the number of visitors to the historic center to 8,000 per day, and to redefine the outstanding universal value of the site. We also managed to, UNESCO also defined that the tourism strategy as a baseline document should be delivered, as well as management plan for the old city center. Those are also those steps are taking place right now, and then arises the question: how can we handle those issues? Can we use the same set of institutions, the same set of actors which led to the present state to be able to resolve them, or do we need to reshape the current institutions and perhaps involve citizens more clearly into delivering and addressing issues as well as delivering solutions. So that was the reason why we decided that as a citizen initiative we tried to take part in the decision process, and we have to step into city council to be able to articulate those issues and to offer some results. We also have very, very specific principles that we are not that are, as to say, not negotiable, that decisions that are crucial should be delivered by most consensus. For instance, those are questions regarding budget planning, regarding special planning, regarding education and social policies. And we also try to negotiate with all the parties, all the stakeholders involved in the city council, no matter how many time does it take. We also attempt to include citizens, and citizen participation is crucial because citizens are the ones that are having the most stress with this uncontrolled development. Our results in the last couple of years resulted in success that we managed to deliver the budget with the 100% consensus for 1 year. We also changed the public space rulebook in 2016. The results of that should be seen in the years coming by lowering the number of the public spaces that are occupied and that are not available to the public, that are occupied by the restaurants and so on. And we managed to initiate the development of historic center management plan. We also worked much on digital economy action plan and offered specific solutions in tourism management processes regarding the traffic management systems, regarding the tourist number monitoring systems, queue management system, and some improvements to the existing roaming card system. I'll just walk you a little very fast through those projects. Since the UNESCO initiated that we have to handle the number of visitors, one of the solutions already deployed in the city of Dubrovnik is so-called people counter. This number of surveillance cameras installed at city entrances, which are able to anonymously count every visitor entering or leaving the city and giving you approximate figure of the number of visitors within the city. No special actions have been taken no special actions are taken right now in order to stop the number of visitors entering or leaving the city. Now we have a stable monitoring system. We also wanted to see if those crowds can be used to offer some more informed decisions to the policymakers. For instance, if we can use the location from the anonymously, location from the mobile network data, we can see where the people are coming from, where do they stay, how long are they going to stay, how long have been staying in the area, or which other places they have visited. All those data were used in one of the pilot projects initiated by the city government, in which we analyzed the data from the mobile networks and concluded at certain spots which number of how many visitors arrived according, and those numbers could exactly be matched to the events taking place at that time. So now it's completely a system that enables you with no questioning to be able to count the number of people at certain spots. This is also one successfully developed pilot project. And all those projects that were triggered as isolated solutions, like smart parking, like surveillance system, like counting cameras and so on, we realized that we can assess them the right way. We can even trigger the whole new economic development based on that. So by addressing those issues and resolving those issues the proper way, it can be it can propel the development of the digital economy. So that are the basis of the development of the digital economic management plan that we have rolled out a few weeks ago. So in order to all those challenges that Dubrovnik is facing, if addressed and resolved in the proper way by using the high technology solutions, can become at last the advantages. So as we conclude, our goal was by entering the institutional, so the institution needs transformation that can be and must be triggered by the citizens, and civil initiatives are really the only ones capable to address those issues and offer suggested solutions. And necessary steps really need to be done in order to position yourself in the way of not looking at the things, but try to start changing the things, and in that place you have to be more important role in the decision-making process. Thank you very much. If you have any questions, I'll be glad to respond.